find yourself in the Beachview area of Pittsburgh, check out the official pizza of this show, Slice on Broadway, sharing an abnormal obsession with pizza we can relate to. Check them out at sliceonbroadway.com and tell them this show sent you. It's the AwesomeCast episode 277. I'm Mike Sorg at Sorgatron on the Twitters here in the Mayhem Studios in Pittsburgh. PA, ready to talk technology from the geeky people in Pittsburgh using it for things or my bobs. I am a video producer and podcaster here in Pittsburgh using a lot of these thingy-bobs and the doohickeys and the detachables. And also with me, another fan of the doohickeys and the detachables is John Chichilla at Chilla on the Twitter. He is the gadget hound extraordinaire on staff with us here.
I like my doohickeys detachable.
Show title!
And then we're done for the night.
Yeah, Chilla on the Twitter if you want to talk doohickeys with him online. Also with us.
Please only do it with a safe search.
It's Katie Dudders at Katie Dudders on the Twitter.
Hi, friends.
She's a social media peoples.
I like my doohickeys attached.
Be safe and crypt.
She uses her doohickeys to be sociable.
I like social doohickeys.
And that sets the tone for the show. How you guys doing?
Not too shabby. How are you?
All right. So this is the AwesomeCast. Like I said, you can check us out at AwesomeCast.net. Add AwesomeCast on the Twitter. Check us out also on the Facebook and the Facebook group. You follow us, subscribe to us on the iTunes. Definitely a big, big help, especially if you can drop a star rating or a review over there. That goes a long way. You can also subscribe to video and audio formats over on the YouTube, on iHeartRadio, on Stitcher, Spreaker, and the like, wherever you can hit up the Awesome Cast. And also check out the Awesome Chat. We have some great interviews happening all the time. Sometimes not this week, but all the other times. So go check that out. So much more at AwesomeCast.net. And also check out our Patreon, patreon.com/AwesomeCast. That's where you can support the show. You don't have to. If you don't want to put a couple bucks towards us, that's okay. But please just share the show. Let other people know about it that you think would be into our Pittsburgh state of mind of technology. And a big thanks to our friends who are supporting the show in this means over on patreon.com/AwesomeCast, including Mike Fedora, Mike Fedora Show on the Twitters, and Thistle C Business Development at Thistle C on the Twitters. I've been supporting us for a good while now, and they got business cards to prove it out there. So that's what you get when you're an executive producer on the show, and you can too, Patreon. All right, so let's get into the show. First, guys, can I do a little bit of show and tell here? Now, Chilla, actually, this was based on your recommendation.
That's a while ago recommendation.
Well, you gave me an iPad from a while ago. So this is an iPad 3. Yes, this is the thing that I traded my Google Glass to you for, along with the old Pebble. And I picked up the Zag keyboard for the iPad 3. And I don't know. I don't think you physically had one to show off at the time, right?
Like we didn't have that one,
right? Like there were yeah. There were just like there were other ones coming out, and you've had ones in the past.
I think I had the Zag for the one.
Okay,
I had the Zag for the one, and I had the Zag for the two.
So,
and then,
so,
in fact, I think Kraus has my Zag for the one because he actually bought my iPad one. I think
off Kraus has an iPad, or is it for his wife?
I think it went to her son.
Mrs. Crazy Krause.
Mrs. Crazy Krause.
The now
son.
Mrs. Crazy Krause, as we talked about last week. Well, I when we come down here, I stick my old iPads on this. It also from Chilla in his hand-me-down stasis we have here. You know, the original Apple iPad keyboard, right? And it's just a typical Apple keyboard. And you pop it right on there. And I just realized how much easier it was to use the iPad when you had a real keyboard to get some extra stuff done. And you've seen my, you know, I've had this kind of cheap one that I bought for Missy a while ago for the iPad 1. It was kind of a gummy keyboard, and I kept mistyping things. I was getting, you know, it just was frustrating. And plus, I had to stick pens in it because it really wasn't made for that size iPad. So I was like, finally, I found this thing. This is a $100 keyboard retail I found for $30 on Amazon, which it's really nice when you have older Apple hardware because all the accessories just drop like a rock in price. So I've only spent about an evening with this, to be honest. Haven't had a lot of time with it. But I can definitely see, one, I can set this thing on my lap. Now, this also, dude, there's magnets in here.
Whoa.
Look at that.
How do they work?
I didn't think I did this upside down because it's not magneting right. I didn't realize there was a right and wrong way. But it does the whole screen on and off thing, just like the magic cover. And I don't like, so it's naked otherwise. I've already dropped this thing because I plugged everything in on a shelf and forgot everything was plugged in and just slipped out of my hands. So durable, yes. Made of, looks like mostly the same kind of aluminum that that the iPad itself is. So it blends very, very nicely. And it's a nice physical keyboard. It's a really well made, I would say about equivalent to the Apple brand one. So, and, you know, right off the bat, just kind of repaired it, ready to go. Like I said, it sits on my lap. I can see myself in some cases when I want to do certain work, just taking this thing, because iPad 3 is plenty capable.
I feel like it's a great blogging device where you're not going to get sidetracked.
Right, right. Mm-hmm. If you're like, I just need to sit down and work on writing,
I need to
newsletter.
Pump out 500 words, or I need to do some text-based tasks. I think that's the perfect,
right,
the perfect device and perfect setup for doing that, because you're not going to, you really can't get that sidetracked. You right. can throw on some music to help you along, but you're not going to you're not going to be like, well, you know, now I'm going to go do this and that. Like, that's what I find when I sit down at my laptop. I'm like, oh, I can go check this website out while I watch this movie and I do this.
And then you realize, like, even just going from task to task, like, that's going through a lot of stuff today. And when I have a lot of things I need to do, I blend from one task to the other. And until I get to the point that I'm, like, working on one thing for a while. Then I forgot I've had these three tabs up for the website in the middle here. Start doing that. All right, Photoshop was up because I was working on that. And I just start, like, moving from task and like entire project mm-hmm. almost, and which is my own, like, you know, issue with organization and why I need to segment out things a little bit. And actually I'm going to be talking about that a little bit this week on basic ergonomics. I want to talk about some getting things done that I've been doing so far. I need so much to improve, and remember the milk, which I just re-upped for pro, which I hadn't for a little bit, and I forgot how awesome it was when you actually pay for it. So we'll begin into that. So look at basic ergonomics on Sorgatron.com for that stuff. But it is the Zag keyboard, and it's, like I said, about $30 for the iPad 3. I think it's iPad 1, 2, and 3 version, if I'm not mistaken. Maybe 3 and 4.
Two, three, and four.
But you look for them, like, if you have an older iPad, it's pretty good prices, look like, down the line for them. And they have them for different sizes. Like, they have them for the minis and everything. So I definitely have a recommendation now for that one. So go check it out. Zag, Z-A-G-G keyboard.
Zag did the screen protectors too.
Yeah, I think they were one of the first to do screen protectors, and I still think they have one of the nicest keyboards as far as key spacing and mm-hmm. feel and what do they call it? Not bounce, but how the key bounce back.
Spring or whatever. Yeah. Something.
I feel like they do definitely do a good job. I think no matter what, if you're on a mini type device or a 7-inch device, I think the keyboards for me get a little scrunched.
Oh, yeah, and my fingers are long and I can't.
Yes, so that. Yeah. But I think that's no matter whose device you have, it's there's a it's isn't it throw the key throw?
I've never heard of that actually.
Yeah, I think it's a thing.
Somebody out there correct
Andy
us.
Inoko is big on, I think, the throw.
All right. Katie, what do you have?
Hey, did you see Zuckerberg is giving away 99% of his stock shares?
What?
I know. Yeah, and he's all into the maternity and paternity leave. And yeah, he's giving away because he wants to invest in his future because he's now has a daughter. Mm. He's got a kid. Changes everything. That's what we hear. Chilla, is that true?
It kind of does. You start to think about things in a different manner.
But apparently he's a little concerned about the future, and he wants it to be a better place. So it's now the Chun Zuckerberg Foundation that they're working on. And it's also, and Bill Gates recently donated a ton of money to future stuff. And his was called...
Future stuff, huh?
Future stuff. That's where I'm at today. Future stuff. The Breakthrough Energy Coalition. That's what it was.
And he's been doing that for a bit too.
Yeah.
He's had the the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation for a while. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, that's what happens when you make too much money.
Yeah.
Good, good. They're not just hoarding. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I mean, I think that's good to see.
So are these tech billionaires going to save our future?
I think that's the case, isn't it? I mean, you have your Elon Musks, mm-hmm. you know, doing what he's doing with energy, you know, efficiency. And it's a business, but it's, and there was a really good discussion actually on, I think, Daily Tech News Show, where, and part of this world, you know, health conference is happening. I think Obama's part of it. Or, I think it's over in France. Mm-hmm. And they're talking about how, you know, healing the world, like environmentally, might actually be a good business move, mm-hmm. you know, and how they can monetize that type of thing, which I think you see with Tesla and the batteries that they've been talking about, that we talked about on the show here.
Mm-hmm.
From the technology side, at least. And there's a whole bunch of other things you could do. But no, I think this is good. And I've seen articles popping up where from women saying, you know, him taking this time for maternity, you know, as a father, mm-hmm. you know, which I think typically are not expected to take quite as much time
mm-hmm.
in general, but helps everybody.
Yeah.
You know, now that he's a grand example of, look, he took 6 weeks, you know, which is, you know, we probably should take 6 weeks. Mm-hmm. And a lot of people don't have the options. I'm probably not taking a maternity leave so much as an independent producer, you know. but something like that. I think it's really cool, you know, especially for as much as we kind of, he gets bashed on for Facebook in general, right?
Yeah.
That's very true.
So.
The focus, the initial focuses are personalized learning, curing diseases, and connecting people and creating strong communities,
mm-hmm.
which I think especially the strong community part is going to be huge. Mm-hmm. And it's something that's much needed at this point because everybody's been so separated along political, economical, every sort of divide at this point. It's I think it's really bad right now. And I think if he could figure out, I mean, if anybody, I mean, Facebook's algorithm, if they can figure, I mean, they own us. If they could figure out a way to fix our communities, it would be them, if anyone.
You know, and it's, you know, thinking about Google already does a lot of data sets that help third world issues,
mm-hmm.
from arms to other things. There's somebody from Google speaking about that a couple years ago. I got to see here in town. And Facebook maybe doesn't have all of those data sets that they have, but they certainly have a lot of people powered ones. Right.
And they definitely have reach.
Oh, yeah. Oh yeah,
they have reach into the hearts, minds, and thoughts of the majority of the population.
Yeah.
So I think that's where they can definitely get out in front in this manner.
So Missy's saying, you know, which of these tech billionaires is going to be Batman? Kraus says definitely Zuckerberg. Gates is too old. I don't know, man. If Commissioner Gordon can be Batman right now in the comic books, I think Gates can create a robotic bat suit. And he can completely do it.
I would say Musk, Elon would be closer to mm-hmm. Batman. I think he would be more the modern day Tony Stark.
Yeah, keep saying Tony Stark. Yeah, and I mean, he's going to have wonderful battery technology in that Iron Man suit, right?
Definitely. So,
I mean, but no, he could do whatever the heck he wanted to, huh?
Yes.
I mean, maybe he is. You don't know. You don't know. Let's see, Elon Musk just tossed around tanks in the Middle East anytime soon. Anyways. Chilla, what do you got?
So I decided, I think I talked about it last week, I'm going to do one OS and gifts that I would give and awesome things out of that OS. So mm-hmm. this week it's Android. So today I found Snap, which takes Android widgets and puts them in your system drawer, kind of the pull down drawer mm-hmm. menu. It's free if you want quick access to 3 widgets. I'm a huge widget person. I have actually a panel on my tablets and even on my phones in some cases, if they're Android, I will actually dedicate an entire page to widgets, especially if they're quick widgets for like turning off Bluetooth, turning on Bluetooth, automatically setting brightness settings. And then I'll have another widget panel with Twitter feeds and Facebook feeds and quick posts and Google Drive, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. So this lets you, the problem is that every time you're in an app, you then have to go back to your home screen to get to these types of things. This lets you quickly put 3 right in that dropdown. For an additional $2, you can remove the 3 widget max. And I think it's, will give you unlimited. I think that's the number. But cool little gadget tech toy for Android users out there. Definitely will come in handy, and it's anywhere between free and $2. So it probably comes right in at that right price if you're using, as long as you're using widgets, which I would think that most Android users, if you're using Android, that would be one of the big plays and reasons to use Android. So
certainly, you cannot beat Android for customizability.
Yes, definitely. I mean,
really, it's the power user device. I go to, if you're the power user, man, that's how many people came up to me and was like, yeah, I'm on Android now, see me with my iPhone. I was like, cool, that's it's a viable choice. Mm-hmm. No, I there's no discount to Android. It's not the thing for me, but you know, and I play with both. I still have the Nexus. The Nexus is the poking around on the internet before bed device for me, you know.
I wish Google, if you're listening, another Nexus 7-inch device I think would be perfect.
Yeah, what the heck. Please. I mean, it was perfect.
We got Marshmallow. I don't know if you got your Marshmallow update. I got my Marshmallow update on my...
I got it a couple weeks ago,
yeah,
actually.
I got it a couple weeks ago. Yeah. But I have a feeling that's going to be... The 2013 7-inch didn't get it. So it was only the second generation Nexus 7 that got it. And then they jumped... That year, they had a 7 and a 9-inch. And then, I mean, it seems like they're kind of going 9 on forward. I feel like there's definitely room for a Nexus 7-inch. I don't care who they partner with to make it, whether it's Zeus, LG, Samsung, whomever, I don't care. But a nice day one OS upgraded Android device, I think there's definitely room for that in the market.
Certainly, certainly. All right. Well, you know what there is always room for?
Too far away.
Use the force
and bring the pizza to you. It's Slice on Broadway, our friends right here up in the Beachview area, providing the perfect pepperoni pizza, supporting Pittsburgh podcasting for well over a year and a half now. Rico and the gang, just really awesome, representing, making some great stuff over there. Right along the tracks here in Beachview, or over on Main Street in Carnegie, PA. So please check them out if you're in the area. I know we have a lot of people not in the area coming in. Mad Mike was just in here a couple weeks ago, and he was craving on the Slice on Broadway, and I'm really glad we could get him some of that and get him in studio as we do. That's what we just kind of coax people in with their with the pizza. Look at that stuff. If you're on the video, you're seeing it. It's real awesome. Follow them at @PGH_Slice on the Twitters. Let them know you heard about them on the AwesomeCast. And follow them on Facebook and Instagram and get hungry too. Thank you so much, Slice on Broadway, for their support of the AwesomeCast. Awesome pizza for an awesome cast. All right, Katie, what is your awesome app of the week?
Oh, guess what we're all doing now? Shopping.
Yeah, more so than I expected. It's all like, I'm not going to do the whole Black Friday. I'm not going to do any of this stuff. And while I'm not standing in lines like a crazy person, I did a lot of shopping this weekend.
Oh my gosh, me too. I was in brick and mortar. I was online. I was everywhere shopping.
Most people I talked to, I heard about a lot of online shopping. I heard a couple people saying they went out foot to the pavement, but I definitely saw an uptick in the amount of online from family members that I thought that wouldn't necessarily do online, to the younger generations. Definitely the interesting thing, I thought it seemed like Black Friday, or was it, what did you call it? Cyber Monday. Black Friday, a lot of places said start your Black Friday the day before Thanksgiving online. So wouldn't that be start Cyber Monday?
Didn't Amazon had Cyber or Black Friday week, Cyber Monday week? You know, like they're just like they don't.
It's no longer a day.
We're taking it from your app, but so they did the same thing like the Prime Day they did a while ago, and I realized I'm looking at this thing and there's like a certain number they fulfill at that price. I'm like, this is Woot.
Yeah,
like they took the Woot mechanism, which they own Woot. They bought Woot, but they're just doing that thing on Amazon's site. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm less like, did they have to buy a patent for this? Or, you know, is that why they bought them? But
Target's Black Friday, I think, was 72 hours. It started in stores Thursday evening.
Whatever. It started at 5 o'clock. I'm sorry. This is a side note. It pisses me off that they started at 5 o'clock on Thursday. It's like, dinner, man.
You know who ruined it?
Huh.
You know who ruined it? The people that were leaving Thanksgiving dinner and going to camp out for Black Friday.
Yeah, they're like, well,
so they're like, why don't we just open the doors?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. But even like I was talking with, so my brother works at Walmart, and when I was prodding him for Black Friday stories, and I was asking, like, can he, like, you know, restrain people if they get a little too unruly? What's the craziest? Because this is his third year, I think, doing it. So I asked,
can he put stuff to the side?
I'm like, yeah, can you do that? Like, do you have to wear a cup? Does it get that bad? You know, that kind of thing. But you know, I don't know. I didn't hear too much crazy, but I also don't watch the news to see all the sensationalism happening, which I'm sure was out there. So. Sound like everybody was getting a little more organized.
Mm-hmm. Target, I know you weren't allowed to wait in their main line area.
Right,
they had all their lines.
One queue.
Like, yeah, one queue off to the side, and then they filtered people.
That's what
over.
Like Walmart had. Like everything was lined up, and they were in cattle herders, like mm-hmm. like Kenny Wood waiting for a ride, and they're like all the deals were in a line basically. And then Best Buy was only letting 100 people in at a time. You know, like they don't want you. Hey, you know what? They don't want pushing and stabbing happening on Black Friday.
Well, and the one thing I learned too for this year, because I was actually thinking about buying a TV. I was actually going to buy a UHD mm-hmm. TV. And after I started doing a bunch of research and looking at like, oh, this is an amazing price or this is really good. And like the Target one was a really good price on the one that I was looking at. But what I quickly learned was that certain manufacturers have certain agreements with certain retailers for Black Friday TVs. Mm-hmm. And they will make a sidebar TV that is comparable, almost exactly like one of their mainstream TVs, mm-hmm. but it may be short an HDMI port, mm-hmm. or it uses lower quality internal components.
Man, I noticed this with PCs all the way back in like 2004. We picked up a few Black Friday Walmart deal PCs that came with the monitor and everything. Mm-hmm. One of those might be sitting over there actually. And I noticed like I looked them up and they were a very specific thing and missing certain key components or maybe a little less RAM or something like that, you know? And you know, that's, you don't want that Black Friday TV.
Mm-hmm.
There's people who have reportedly taken some of them home and they're like not working, you know, and who do you call, you know, at that point?
So I'm going to wait for the deals that go on right before the Super Bowl.
Yeah, those are the times about the TVs.
Because those aren't a special. Those are usually because they're coming to the end of the life cycle and mm-hmm. the new cycle starts in the early spring. So that's right. When I think I'll be purchasing my next TV.
Right. Anyway, so there's an app.
and hopefully this app will help me buy a TV when the time comes.
I want to talk about my Black Friday shopping. I was out Thursday night, I was out Friday, and I was out Saturday. I was out every single day shopping. Thursday night was very calm and very nice because everybody was just like, oh, we need to get out of the house. Like when people go to the movies on Thanksgiving. I think that was part of the problem too, is, oh, we can only have so many people at the movies. Let's send them to the stores. And there were a lot of deals. Like when I went to Target, there were a lot of deals. There were still piles of TVs. Like I was surprised mm-hmm. and it was very orderly and everybody, mm-hmm. like you said, was very calm. Mm-hmm. Friday, Black Friday was not bad. I think Saturday was the worst day. That was the day that everybody was out and about.
Mm-hmm. Sunday was kind of rough.
Yeah. It was like the weekend was worse because I went to Target. I went to Target Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. I do not have a Target problem, I swear. But yeah, I was there every day. And I was at Kohl's on Friday. Black Friday, I was at Kohl's, and it was not bad.
We ended up at Target like three times this weekend, too. It's weird.
Well, Target did a thing, which I was really digging, was they had a different deal every day. The Saturday, you know, Thursday there was, I don't remember what I had the deal on Thursday. Wednesday was buy one, get one free pizzas. Thursday was something else. Yeah, because I love their pizzas. Friday, I don't remember the deal for Friday, but I held out for Saturday because they had $50 off a $100 Christmas purchase at the store. It was a coupon, which was fantastic. And today they had 25% off health and beauty items. So they're doing these different coupons that you can, which don't necessarily, you don't have to buy anything. You can get them online. You can actually, there's signs throughout the store that you can get them text. You just text to Target. And they will send you the coupon on your phone. You'll get the barcode. They also do that with toys and various things with each season, which I really like their text coupons because then you don't feel like, oh, man, I didn't get the paper and everybody else got the deal but me. So I really think Target is really taking advantage of all the tech now. Mm-hmm. That, I mean, they're just attacking you from every angle. Oh, you don't have a, you really don't have a smartphone? That's fine. You just text us and we can do this, mm-hmm. which I think is really cool.
I used that on Christmas lights last year mm-hmm. and on something at Halloween time, like candy or something. And it is so useful to just type in the text mm-hmm. and they scan it at the register.
And then they put it out there. I love the fact that it's right there mm-hmm. next to the items. And you're mm-hmm. like, oh, yeah, I didn't even realize this was going on. But I did get a dinosaur, one of those dinosaur yard decorations, the ones.
Is that what was riding in the back seat?
Yes, that was my dinosaur.
You sent me.
I technically spent $4 on him.
How big was he?
He's like this big.
He's a pretty good size.
He's like 3.5 foot. Almost four
like
foot
he
tall.
Could wear a seatbelt.
Yeah, he's adorable. But yeah, so my $50 off $100. I needed tinsel, got a new tree, so I needed tinsel. I needed garland. I mean, everything since we moved into a new place. I needed everything, so it was perfect. So I spent $4 on the dinosaur. So yeah, thank you, Target. But the app I have to talk about, it's called Red Laser, and it's been around for a little while, and it's an eBay-owned app. So it's not, we're familiar with a lot of the Amazon barcode apps, and this one is eBay-owned. So you get a lot more options, because I think eBay is kind of, well, I with Amazon, you have kind of the main options, and here's a few additional ones. With eBay, you have every version. You have a used version, you have a kind of used version, you have, so you get the actual prices of things in the stores near you. You get what's available on eBay. And well, something else neat that I really like is they have the keychain. I used to be the keychain app, but it's very similar to the keychain app where you can keep your rewards on there too. So you're not just scanning to get the best price on a UPC. You can also go, oh, I'm at Toys R Us. Let me pull up my Toys R Us key ring so I don't have to weigh down my keys with these 50,000 key rings or dig through. That's always embarrassing. I know it's here. Then you have your Borders and all the other stores that have closed on your key ring still.
Yeah.
If you're me, at least, you still have all those on your keychain.
You have like, your Blockbuster card.
Yeah, Farmore. I'm in. Farmore was probably pre-UPC.
I don't even think they had a loyalty card at Farmore. Just
Farmore.
Yeah, pull out Farmore. What's up, guys?
I just replaced my Giant Eagle Advantage card this weekend because it wouldn't read on the self-checkout. I don't go to Giant Eagle all that much, but it still had like my name on it and everything mm-hmm. from back in the day. It's split in half and stuff. I'm still using it at Geckos. So, but anyways, Red Laser. So
Red Laser, yes.
So I got it right here to check it out. I mean, there's not much to it. I mean, it's just kind of a shopping app. So yeah. I mean, so I can put my cards into it, right? Mm-hmm. So and then beyond that, what all can I kind of get into?
You
here?
Can also save favorites.
Okay,
you're looking for something. You can either enter it by barcode, or mm-hmm. I think you can search. I don't know. I'm looking for a TV. Woo, TV.
But the one thing that I've heard people use this for is especially on like the Black Friday or big sale days, you can go into a store and you can say, you can use this app to scan the barcode on something in the store. So say Monopoly is on sale for 99 cents for the board game, for like a $20 board game, right? You can actually go and look to see like on eBay and on other company sites to see what the going price is for that item.
So this is definitely like the, you know, worst nightmare of brick and mortar at this point.
Yeah. But then if the price is higher everywhere else, including like eBay as just personal sellers, you can then go buy this and then take it home and start selling on eBay or on Amazon. and that's like one of the big tricks for the big sellers are, the end of summer sales for swimmy diapers for kids. I know people that will buy up every lot after Labor Day hits, and they will sell them year round for all the people that are end up going on like nice vacations in the wintertime, and they need diapers for their kids, swimmy diapers for their kids, and now they're selling them on Amazon for like four times what they bought them for.
Wow.
I know people at work that when Target has some kind of limited edition, like manufacturer or designer selling clothes in the summertime, mm-hmm. they'll go in and buy the entire lot out of every Target they can get to and then put them on eBay for four times the price.
Jeez.
Oh, gosh.
So I mean, this isn't just a find yourself a deal. This is a see what the going rate for this product is. Because you might be able to make a buck off of it if you're buying it at a good price, because you can buy it low and sell it high.
Also good if you're at a comic show mm-hmm. or flea market or something as well. Mm-hmm. So yeah, Yeah. Well, I thought eBay in general was really good for that. But mm-hmm. I guess if you can just like pop in the barcode, that really kind of helps things along, mm-hmm. right? So it's Red Laser. Go check that out. This is another app / kind of tip of the week for you. This is let me pull this up so I can kind of snag what the name of. No, that was about headphones. That's not what I was looking for here. So this is an augmented reality. I'm a big fan of augmented reality, hence I had a Google Glass. See the invisible wireless signals around you with this augmented reality app. And it's pretty cool. I'll play with a little bit here before the show. And it's $2.99 on the App Store, on the iOS App Store, if you want to check it out. It's called the Architecture of Radio. And yeah, okay, it does work a lot smoother on that newer iPad than my iPhone 5S, by the way, at least in this video here. And it gives you like kind of an idea of cell towers, looks like Wi-Fis, things like that. Here we'll kind of see what things look like here in Beachview in my studio in a moment here, if you're on video. And it takes a moment, like it has to download, it says it's downloading like kind of Wi-Fi information and everything. And as we're going here, you're seeing a lot of spikes for Wi-Fi signals and everything. And actually, if I turn around, and this is like towards the hill, actually, and it seems like, maybe it's doing it. Yeah, you see a little bit more going on.
Now you see the clouds. Like,
oh,
you're
no.
Flying.
This
you're on a plane.
Whee!
This screensaver, I'll tell you what. But hey, it's working this time. It didn't work last week. But yeah, you get a kind of a sense of how much GPRS, you know, a lot of cell towers, a lot of carriers. You can see where the cell towers are in relation to you. And it is picking up Wi-Fis as well. So now, Chilla.
So point it, because so I just turned the hotspot on my phone.
Ooh, yeah.
So if you pointed it towards me, shouldn't it pick up? It'll say like Chilla's iPhone.
I'm not sure.
So would it? Will
so,
it?
Because I don't know if you can see on here. It's saying Wi-Fi and BSSIDs, and it's giving a number, not like the SSID I would see.
But there's like Genesis 2.
What's this Genesis 2? Miscellaneous Engineering, United States, 2007. What are you doing over there?
I'm just letting you. I'm putting my phone in a different spot than Chilla's phone.
I don't know if it's doing it like.
Like, is it real or is it just picking up tower and known Wi-Fi information?
So there's cell towers, but I don't see anything that kind of looks like. Like
or
I feel
three.
Like the Wi-Fi routers are these little red dots. Okay. And I was seeing satellites too. Oh, I can see satellites. Oh, look at that! That's a communication satellite called Iridium. United States put it up there in 1997, and you can see that. So I think it's a little bit of like we have the data for all this other stuff, but again, I don't know how much. Like, there's a Wi-Fi router like right in front of me, and I don't really see it. You know,
mm-hmm.
You know, I think you're right. It's kind of like a known kind of thing.
Well, because Google, when they do Google Maps, don't they also map out Wi-Fi?
So it might be that information as well. Because did you know there's a Google. There's a Google streetcar that lives about a block away from here.
Oh, really?
Yes.
I did not know
like
that.
Like over on Rutherford. There's like he's parked there. He's probably parked there right now, unless he's out on the job. And the guy lives over there, and they let him drive it home.
Hey, why not?
So I thought that was kind of cool. But they're picking up Wi-Fi. Now, are they still allowed to? I thought they got in trouble for that.
I thought it was they were no longer allowed to post non-broadcast.
Okay.
So... if you're broadcasting and you have and your SSID is broadcast, maybe it's password protected, but if it's broadcasted, I think they're allowed to say, hey, in this location,
there's this. Yeah.
What they were doing was because there are some tools you can use to gather hidden SSIDs. I think they were publishing all the hidden SSIDs in the area.
Of course, Google has it.
Yeah. So I think that's where they were kind of getting themselves into some trouble. But I think you're allowed to do that.
I love in the article they're talking about, it's currently being used as part of an exhibition by a Dutch designer, at the Center of Art and Media in Karlsruhe. Oh, I'm butchering that in Germany. They said that the, website says that app reverses daily experiences by hiding the visible while revealing the invisible technology landscape we interact with through our devices. In this way, peering through the frame of your tablet to peer into this world is a bit like something from The Matrix. Because we have to make a revelation to The Matrix all the time. But wireless routers, distant cell towers, sometimes satellites like we saw there. They're compiled from several public databases, so that kind of gives you the general idea. Mm-hmm. So it is these are big ones that you're typically not going to, like, they aren't going anywhere, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So that's kind of cool. It kind of gives you an idea. Remember, I mean, I've talked about it here and other places, all the waves that are like coursing through our bodies. You know, somebody's downloading porn through me right now is the example I usually give. And I think it's pretty interesting to kind of visualize something like that. So I'm going to play with that a little bit more as I travel here. Have fun with that. All right. So we had a share from real quick. I want to talk about this. So apparently this is a yearly rumor that comes up that Doug shared with us here. Will Apple drop the headphone jack on the iPhone 7? I'm thinking no.
If they drop it here, if they drop it, the headphones that come with it are going to be lightning, and you're also probably going to get some kind of free lightning to headphone jack converter. But I think this is
no. It's not going to be free.
This is not.
It's going to be $30. Let's be honest about this.
No. I think to get probably on the 7S and the 8.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're going to pay like a $30 fee.
Yeah.
But on the 7, the first one that comes out, because don't forget, in every phone, you get a free pair of headphones.
Mm-hmm. Right.
So the headphones they're going to give you are probably going to be lightning, right, or they're going to give you the lightning to headphone converter.
So we're saying we're not going to do headphones that are lightning. We might just have a converter just...
flat. A dongle.
It's a dongle.
Well, because and I've heard more. I'm surprised at the number of audiophiles I find myself talking to, and all of them have either light. If they're an Apple user, they have a Lightning DAC at their house for high quality audio, or they have, if they're an Android user, they have a USB DAC that they use on their PC and on their Android device. And I've heard a lot of people using USB DACs on iPhones using the camera connector kit. So the interesting thing is I think they're going to get, it's actually going to give a higher quality to the sound.
Mm-hmm.
When they do this, I don't think we're ready for this. Just like the MacBook only has the USB-C. I've heard there's 7 iPhone models floating around, iPhone 7 models floating around right now.
And there's usually variations.
Right. So I've heard there's a USB-C one. I've heard there's lightning with no headphone jack. I've heard there's an enhanced force touch. I've heard there's one that the fingerprint sensor is built into the screen. I've heard a number of rumors. And think about it. You could say Apple is testing anything right now, and who knows when it's going to come in. I'm sure they're testing AMOLED, which they've already stated will not come out till at least 2018. So if you can think it up, yes, I'm guessing they're testing it.
Yes.
Is it going to make it to the iPhone 7? Probably not.
Mm-mm. Do you think they would test the Lightning headphones beforehand? Like, do you think they would sell those?
And see, I think that's a good point. I think they would try to start marketing those. Because if sales took off for those, mm-hmm, right, it just gives more reason to drop the headphone jack.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
I could see them saying, trying to upplay Beats Bluetooth devices even more, mm-hmm, if they were truly going to do this. I just don't see it happening.
So if you think about it, you put out the Lightning headphones. They do well. You no longer have to give the adapter once they come out. You're not convincing people to buy the phone, and this is why, you know, one of the reasons why. Oh, it'll be okay, like something to kind of coddle.
The problem I have with Lightning headphones and why I jumped to the dongle theory, mm-hmm, is because the only thing you're going to be able to use those headphones on are an iPhone or an iPad. Mm-hmm. Whereas if you went with Bluetooth or you go with the dongle converter,
mm-hmm,
it's, you can use any set of headphones with that, mm-hmm, theory, versus I can only use it in these two devices. Mm-hmm. It's not like even on the Mac that there's a Lightning port to plug into kind of thing. Mm-hmm. So I don't know. It'll be interesting to see where they go with this. I'd rather see wireless charging in the next phone versus headphone loss of the headphone jack. I use the headphone jack every day. Mm-hmm. I don't know. Sorg, what do you think?
No more dongles.
No more dongles.
No, no.
You're going full wireless.
No, not that either. No.
Well, because I mean, here, because you know that's gonna be the next one.
Yeah.
Let me have my headphone jack, please.
So the iPhone's gonna have no more port. Mm-hmm. Because it's going to charge wirelessly like your watch, and it's your headphones are going to be Bluetooth, mm-hmm. and there's going to be no more buttons, so it's going to be full screen edge to edge because the fingerprint sensor is going to be built in the screen. I mean, I don't know. I see a lot of these in theory sound cool. Mm-hmm. I just don't see it actually.
What is this world
taking off?
Oh, jeez.
All of the dongles.
All right. So, hey, speaking of dongles. I have no segue for this. I have no segue.
Speaking of detachables.
If you are a business, if you are, what?
if you're a detachable dongle. If you're in the detachable dongle business.
Then I have a service for you. Yes. We can help you with your video for that detachable dongle business. The best in the industry. Or at least we'd have a lot of fun with it. SidekickMediaServices.com is where we're doing that. You can go check out a little bit of what we're doing in video, in social media, in podcasting. There's Dudders hanging out with a drone. And the guy behind the drone. There's so much going on. We just did actually finished lately a pretty cool project helping out. There's a budget crisis here in PA, and we're helping Pittsburgh Foundation actually serve as primary editor on that project at papeoplecount.org if you want to check out what's going on there. We've been all over the city for the last, 10 years doing some really, really cool videos. We got so much more on the way in technology, in Pittsburghese, in so much more. Just actually helped serve a little bit of engineering duties on yajagoff.com's first, well, technically second podcast. It's going to be coming up here, including Bill Peduto, mayor of Pittsburgh, as a part of that, and other friends like Ginny Montanez of That's Church, and the former Pick Girl, of course, and so many more representing Pittsburgh. So check that out coming up at jagoff.com. I know he put a post about it coming up today on the blog, and I think he's going to be releasing it sometime this week. So if you have some technical needs you need a hand with, sidekickmediaservices.com is where to go. So let's see what else we're making here around Sorgatron Media. Last week at SorgatronMedia.com. We'll be right back.
It's a purely notification device. That's what I like it for, you know, whereas the Apple device is more
It wants to do everything else.
Exactly.
Right?
Yeah, this is just notifications. It does fitness tracking, which God knows I could use more of. Notifications and steps. It also does stairwells now, which it didn't. The last one didn't do.
I'm a freak for the WCW Cruiserweight Division. When I dig down and look at the original Heavenly Bodies and a lot of Simon Dean, obviously.
From the chat, Eamon is saying, push Big E, NXT, Kofi, fire Xavier. He will have a home at Inspire Wrestling.
Dongles for your drones.
Dongles for your drones.
Don's House of Drones and Dongles.
Drones and Dongles. We had a dongle discussion here on the break here. Check out everything else going on that's dongle and not dongle related over at SorgatronMedia.com, of course. And not featured there, but a great Sawtooth Willie with his intern. A lot of fun over there as well. So Amazon has a new video about their drone service. And it has a familiar face if you are a fan of Top Gear. And it's a pretty good scenario they lay out here. So I'm glad that acquisition of the former Top Gear stars is already working out for Amazon. Here, you have to talk about drones instead of cars. Here you go. But they demonstrated, I don't know what stage this is at. I think this is more just kind of PR. Hey, this is the thing we want to get to. But they show a new version of the drone. They show like Millennium Falcon style.
Yeah, I know. I know. That's exactly loaded. What I thought. It's like takes off like the Millennium Falcon.
What is this? And talking about how the drone will go 15 miles out to deliver your soccer kid a pair of shoes because the dog ate one of them, and take off and land right there in the field, and you get a notification on your Amazon tablet. I'm sure an Android device will work as well here. Here I like the Terminator style POV that they did on the drone was pretty cool. No, they had a lot of fun with this. Like I said, very Top Gear style, or at least very British style, and that's just quaint to me. I don't know, like, I don't think it's going
to
work.
Do you have to have the little A thing for them to deliver on?
Yeah, do I have to put, like, a little, like, Amazon square? Yeah, you do. She picks it up.
Yeah, she picks it up.
She picks it up when she picks up the box, too. I'll go back to that. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it lands right on the little A. I guess it looks for it. Mm-hmm. And then you pick it up and you take your A inside. So I got to run out back, you know. So hopefully you got a
This is the Amazon landing zone.
Yeah, exactly. Do I have to pay for it, like the Tide button? You know,
but you get reimbursed the first time you use it.
Yeah, exactly. And there you go. I think it's a pretty fun, interesting demonstration. I wish I had grocery service, to be honest. The more I keep thinking about how much I don't want to go get groceries when it comes to Amazon. But guys, this is close. It feels like, at least in their representation of it, right?
It's
sorry. I forgot
the touchscreen. Sorry. Very cool. There's, I'd rather have Echo personally.
What do you mean?
Like if I could have like different Amazon services, I don't have an Echo right now. I would rather have an Echo than an Amazon Prime Air, personally. Okay. I just don't. For me, I don't see the use in this, but I'm sure. See, now what would be cool is if the girl had her shoes eaten on the way to soccer.
Oh.
They order the shoes on the drive. Mom throws out the A into the field and boom, it like lands. Like instantaneous.
That's a little, okay. You're throwing an extra wrinkle in there, okay? I don't know about this. No, I think it's still like how many, you know, bees, I work at home. Right? Bless you. And I'm just like, oh, I need a hard drive. I just ran out of space. I need a hard drive. And I order up a thing and I have a hard drive in like a half an hour. Instead of going or ink. Holy crap. Ink.
Unless there's a windstorm. Sorry, we couldn't deliver your hard drive today.
Weather permitting, you know? And that's the other thing. So I know from work I've done talking about another drone. And now there is probably a different method, but the thing that they work with, it has a problem because it's a thing that reads the topography, right?
Mm-hmm.
And they talk about they have a problem when there's snow. Mm. Are you going? Is that Amazon logo going to pop out when my yard is covered in snow, for instance? So I don't know. It's going to be an interesting thing to solve. This is going to be regional. You know, this is going to be cities. We're like, okay, we can definitely do this in LA. We can't do this in Pittsburgh because of, you know, this factor, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know, something like that. Yes, I will never leave the house. Hey, have you seen all the Amazon boxes that showed up this week? I'm ordering coffee. I'm ordering dog food. I'm ordering stuff for the studio. I'm ordering stuff for video production. Like, it's like everything going on right now. And you know what? I'm kind of okay with that. Because guess what? I hate going to the store. Any of them.
I can't wait till you stop, like, cutting your hair and grow your beard and stop. You know, Howard Hughes. Was that Howard?
Yeah.
Style. I'm actually picturing you as Mr. Burns.
Don't.
Where he's with the tissue boxes on his shoe feet. That episode where he doesn't want to leave the house anymore. Because he's afraid of diseases.
Yeah. Just like here in the co-working space. I got enough. I got like three offices. I don't need stores to go to, you know, and I'm okay with that. I mean, it gives you time to, like, instead of taking an evening to go to a store, mm-hmm. you can do other things, mm-hmm. you know, and I think that's really important. A lot of things I listen to, especially the Vaynerchuk stuff, is like, you know what's really important right now? You know what Uber is not a car business, it's a time business. Mm-hmm. You know, they're selling you time that you don't have to worry about dealing with your car, finding a taxi, you know, all that kind of other stuff. It's just there and it works, right? Mm-hmm. You hit a button. Mike, not only did he get over here for pizza, but he's also using Uber to get around Pittsburgh the entire week he was here. And he said it was great. It was a great service. And he lived on it for a week. Mm-hmm. It's good.
Mm-hmm. It works.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Yep.
I think online ordering is better for me because I am one of those people, if I don't do it right now, I may forget. It's like, oh, I need to do this and I don't have time to get to the store. But if I could just do this, I've got it. Like, oh, somebody said this is cool. I should just get it now instead of waiting until I go to the store and forget about it when I go to Target.
Mm-hmm. Katie, tell me, you're saying that Chilla missed out on a little bit of a trend here.
You missed out on a tech trend.
On a trend?
So sad.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I'm surprised, Chilla. You lost a step here.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Christopher is not a name of a Instagram.
Oh,
filter.
I read this today. I read this actually. I read this out loud at work, and people thought I was insane. And I'm like, no, this is an article on the internet.
Is this an Onion article? What?
No, it was it, no. It's
like TechCrunch.
It's legitimate.
A lot of Luxes.
A lot of Lux.
Yeah.
And Valencia was a female name.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So that's
Juno, Valencia, and Willow.
So they're not, I mean, they're not in the top baby names, but they're getting a huge surge.
Right.
And what people want to name their kids.
Why does that kid have such an old iPhone?
Obviously, its parents don't love it.
No.
Nobody loves you, baby.
Wow, the Instagram effect. So here, yeah, Lux is up 75%. Mm-hmm. Who names their kid Lux? What is that?
Who doesn't?
Who doesn't? There you go.
Obviously, just
Ludwig?
Juno.
Is that Juno? Well, yeah. That was also
Juno's for the female.
It's also a movie. Amaro, Valencia, Willow, and is that Reyes?
Yes.
Wow.
Is that another spelling for Reese?
Ooh, I don't know. We should ask people at Instagram.
I don't know. I think it depends on what ethnicity you are. Yeah. Yeah. Because there's a wrestler that goes by that as Reyes, but it's like a last name, so I don't know. But there you go.
So, yeah, he totally, there's still time for what, I like the Clarendon.
Nashville.
Yes. Slumber. Mayfair. That's a pretty name. I don't know.
Isn't there a year?
Wasn't Hudson on here? Because that would be a good, that's a name.
Isn't there an Instagram year? One that's a year.
Inkwell? Oh, yeah, it was like 19. Lo-fi. Oh, my gosh. You have twins, X-Pro and Lo-fi. That's where we missed a lot here. Aiden. These are all Moon. Yeah, there's a lot of options that didn't make the list. I'm surprised. Or maybe they actually sound real like enough names that they were like, this didn't show up on our radar. Yeah, so Chilla missed a trend. I'm very disappointed.
Well, the one thing you won't miss out on is if you go to Google, check this out. If you go to google.com and you type in a long time ago in a galaxy far, far away.
Oh, crap.
Guess what? You're not going to have to finish it because it's going to pop up. And you get... it didn't do it!
I had a problem trying to do this
the other
day.
You know what? I don't think my Chrome's updated. But what
I didn't think it mattered.
No? Oh, did they stop doing it?
No. I had a long time ago.
No. Well, anyways, what was happening?
Yeah, I got it to work.
Okay, it's my computer. Okay. So I'll just do it over here. But if you do that, you will get a very special version of your Google search to Star Wars.
I thought it had the sound in with it too.
You gotta click the button on it. Oh, there it goes. Oh, it didn't do it here either. What the heck?
And this is for news purposes, so we
exactly don't take down John Williams, please. But no, it turns your Google search into a crawl. I can't believe it didn't work on either of these computers. I don't know what I did. A pretty cool Easter egg going on there.
But it's funny because it turns it into a crawl for the search term.
Right, right. You can't search for other things.
You can't search for other things and have it crawl.
Yeah, yeah. So it's pretty cool. It's pretty cool. The geekiness of Google, and the debate was, did they get paid for this? They kind of had to have, or something. There's some deal because they used the John Williams music and everything, mm-hmm. but they've done things with Pac-Man in the past. So,
Or is this a, or is this to get more people, or to keep people sticky with Google?
Yeah, it could be.
I could see it going both ways. Mm-hmm. I mean, everyone wants to wants to ride the Star Wars coolness.
Yeah. Oh, you know what I bought today? Star Wars, you know, the mini packets of tissues at Five Below. Because it was that ridiculous, I had to have it.
My favorite commercial is the macaroni and cheese commercial where the dad takes the kid into the room with all the old toys. And the kid's like, you leave these in the packages, you don't play with them. And then they go over how pointless it is to have the macaroni and cheese that you're not allowed. And then you have the macaroni and cheese that you're not allowed to eat. Like, the commercials are priceless.
I haven't been looking at these, but
Are we gonna have a Star Wars?
There's a whole end cap at Target of Star Wars themed barbecue equipment.
Like, that don't have to be the comeback show because we'll be on hiatus.
Oh, that's right.
Maybe we'll have to have a special edition.
Yeah.
We're gonna have a discussion in Slack about our Christmas episodes, I think.
Oh.
Very soon. So I wanted to go to Chilla. You have your picks for
I have my holiday Amazon Android picks. So, and I've been trying to do kind of prices at every price point. Mm-hmm. So I was thinking on the high end of the price point, if your person, loved one, friend, whatever, is an Android user and they don't have a tablet, there's some good tablets out there. Obviously, they come in more at the $200 to $300 price point. We talked about the Nexus earlier. You can pick up right now $100 off for the Google Nexus 9 tablet. It's an 8.9-inch 16-gig tablet. Obviously, you're going to get day one upgrades. That price point comes in at $299. Both have the 7-inch. I use it all the time. It's a great device. It has a 2.3 gigahertz 64-bit processor, 2 gig of RAM. I think it's definitely worth the $299. It kind of has that 4x3 layout, so it's not 16x9, so it gives you kind of that paper feel, or that the kind of reading a book feel. Followed up by the NVIDIA Shield. It's actually temporarily out of stock because it's doing so well. It's an 8-inch 16-gig tablet as well. NVIDIA has definitely taken and run with the idea of Android as a gaming device, so they have bundles with memory cards and controllers and all kinds of stuff. And I think there's, you can load the apps to a memory card. They have a memory card slot, unlike the Nexus device. So those kind of come in at the $200 to $300 range. If your loved one or friend or whomever that you want to buy an Android device for is a Samsung user, obviously we reviewed the Gear VR here. Gear VR has gone mainstream. That device is for sale now outside of the developer edition. It runs at the $99 price point, and it works with any of the Galaxy 6 and above devices or the Note 5. So if you have the 6, the 6 Plus, the 6 Edge, the 6 Edge Plus, and the Note 5, they're all compatible. I've heard a lot of good comments on the device as far as it's not overheating as much. If you remember when we kind of were playing with the device in studio, that touch panel on the side that was kind of flat, if you look probably the one frame down on that website, you can now see that the touch panel is actually indented to show you go down just a little.
Oh, look
right
at
there.
That. Nice.
So the select button is now dead center. It kind of gives you a feeling of where your finger needs to be for up, down, left, right. And then they have the back button as well. They still have the pass-through USB. Like I said, they're not seeing the overheating that they once were. And the App Store has definitely grown. Leaps and bounds.
So you've seen that kind of growing on your side?
I've definitely seen that growing from Netflix to there's an app now that's free from, I think it's the Wall Street Journal, where they have kind of video walkthroughs of different news sites.
I need to get my, I'm about to just drop $20 to get at least a cardboard so I can start playing with stuff like this.
Yeah. Their theater, they're starting to pull in a lot of the 360 video that's out there from Jurassic World, the Star Wars video. All of that stuff's in their kind of online Oculus theater. Because keep in mind, this is the Galaxy VR, but it's all Oculus brand.
So everything that you're playing with now will be available for the Oculus.
Yes.
So everything you're experiencing now will be better later with the
Oculus.
It's
probably going to be better, but keep in mind that you're powering it all off your existing cell phone, hence the $99 set of goggles. Mm-hmm. Versus when Oculus comes out with their device, it's going to be the computer in the goggle. I'm sure the goggles are going to be heavier. Mm-hmm. They're going to be pricier.
But they're also going to run off the computer, like your computer. Right. Like there's some pretty hefty specs for those.
Yes.
So awesome. And finally, you had one more thing
here. Oh, and for those that are looking for kind of, the sub $50 range, I went with the Andonit. I don't know how to pronounce their
Adonit.
They're a maker of stylus devices. They have the Dash, which is it is a powered device, so it does USB charge. Mm-hmm. But it's a $50 stylus that is cross platform, so it'll work on pretty much anything. And then last but not least, the Chromecast, both audio and video versions. We're all very well versed with what Chromecast has to offer. Obviously, you can get the Chromecast that'll plug into a TV and the audio only version as well. And I'm actually thinking or contemplating when Apple Music is Chromecastable from the Android side, I will probably buy at least two or three of them. Wow. The audio only. Wow. Just to throw on some speakers in different rooms and have an whole house audio for on the cheap.
Is there really a reason to upgrade from a Chromecast 1 to a 2?
Not that I'm aware of.
I'm not seeing it. Yeah. Even like the games we were talking about, I've been waiting and looking and poking for the Angry Birds Go on Chromecast, for instance, and it just hasn't happened yet.
Right.
So, and I'm like, that's a big thing for me. You can still get like Monopoly, which is great. I talked about it here a couple weeks ago, but you know, it's not that. So, I don't know. All right.
So, Android gifts for every price point. And if all else fails, just get them a Amazon or a Google Play card.
Yes.
All right. Well, on that note, it's time to get out of here. Let the guys talk about some video games on Boss Battle from InsertCoinToBegin.com. Go check them out. We have events.
We have events?
We have events.
I thought one of you had something you didn't put in the doc. Okay. I couldn't remember.
Pick me.
Dudders has an event.
Pick me. not personally. Mikey and Bob are collecting coins again. Stuff of Us.
Yes.
They're in a new Robinson location. It's the Home Goods store, which is in one of the side plazas. It's kind of, it's across from IKEA.
It's where Sears used to be. It's where CompUSA used to be.
Oh.
It's next to near where Camelot was. And jeez. Coconuts Music.
It's the plaza of sadness. Jeez.
This is Chilla and make this a theater of sadness. But
it brings back good memories for me, though. I remember all the stores in that location.
Mm-hmm.
But they're collecting toys through Friday. I believe Friday morning is the last time you can drop off toys, but they're there 24 hours a day, all week. They live in an RV. It's an amazing thing they do. I dropped off some toys this morning. They were finishing up bus 2 and working to bus 3, but I think things really pick up as the week goes on because there are schools and organizations that bring pre-filled buses. And then one night, I believe the fire trucks will be out from different fire departments. And it's an event. And I actually chatted with Mikey and Bob for a second, or actually Mikey about it for a second. And he said that his brother was saying how, you know, he had furries visiting him.
Mm-hmm. I saw pictures from that last night.
He's like, is this just like some magical event where everybody can just come as you are and hang out and have fun?
It is.
Yeah, he said they've had wrestlers, you know, they had the primetime players came out.
Mm-hmm.
And there is a rumor of a video of a whole lot of toys. So I don't want to go too much into that, but there's
one. Awesome. It is a good time. Last year when I went out, it was Wednesday or Thursday night, and they get you usually a little more ragged as they go through the week because they've been in a parking lot all week. And I know Bob like huddled me for warmth for instance. And there was the Steel City Ghostbusters were out with the Ecto-1, and the Back to the Future car was out there too. Like, I mean, you never know. And then you just see fire trucks coming in with loads of toys. You know, it's really, really cool to see. And just seeing the pictures of the crazy people that come out there is so great. I saw a crazy Italian guy's mom like made them kielbasa that they were eating at like 8 in the morning.
Yeah, I saw that this morning on Twitter.
That was great. Just to watch like that adventure that happens with there. And it's a really great thing they do. Just an ungodly amount of toys that they do. So, you know, I grab up a couple things, try to head out there every week, every year, and be a part of it. So go do that if you were in the Pittsburgh area. And there are things, like there's some stuff through the Pittsburgh Penguins. It's not up yet, but if you go to their site, there are other methods that you can contribute to this or find the Toys for Tots in your area.
Mm-hmm. I think they have drop-offs in physical locations too.
Yes, they do.
Yeah.
Guys, this has been the Awesome Cast. This has been, yes, awesomecast.net. Check us out. Subscribe to us on all the video and audio formats. Follow us on the Twitters and the Facebooks. And also, you can join us here live, live.awesomecast.net, like the great people in the chat room, like Crazy Krause, Eamon's in there, Juggalo John, Wheels is always in there as well as the gents getting ready for a boss battle here in a few minutes. Of course, thanks to wife of the show, Missy, at Rebellious Flaw on the Twitter for the show notes and the community directions all night long. And with that, thank you, my co-hosts at Chilla. Hi, show's not done yet. At Chilla on the Twitters.
John Chilla on the Facebooks.
Hit them up, especially if you have dongle questions.
Hey, and if you're on Snapchat, I don't even know what my Snapchat name is. We'll bring that up next week. Because I'm trying to get into Snapchat.
Ooh, okay, I like Snapchat.
We'll have a discussion for you. Katie, dude, it's at Katie Dudders on the Twitter.
Let me know about your social dongles.
Yes, I'll share with her your social dongles. Don't, you know what? Let's rephrase that on the internet.
Your social dongles?
Don't give your Snapchat tonight after that statement.
Okay, I'm fine. Okay.
You'll get a lot of social dongles.
They can't beat Penis Picks 1.
No.
I've had that friend.
No.
It's a thing.
Oh, no.
I wonder what he wanted to send me.
And at Sorgatron on the Twitters, of course, and check out everything going out. Sorgatronmedia.com and a lot of the shows going on there, and client podcasts and all kinds of fun stuff. We're getting ready for the holiday edition, December 15th. We confirmed. Who did I confirm? I confirmed like two and a half people for the 15th to join us here. Some of our usual people. Maybe.
I thought that was your name for a minute.
Nope. My name is not Penis Picks 11.
She like showed me her Snapchat and she like pointed to this name and I'm like, should I take that in?
Yes, Penis Picks 11. Add me, Penis Picks 11.
Quick, give me your QR code. Anyways, thank you so much everybody for joining us. Thank you to our awesome chat room. You've been our awesome audience. Have an awesome week. This show is a member of the Sorgatron Media Podcast Network. Find out more at sorgatronmedia.com.